Breastfeeding also has benefits for mothers as well. A review of 47 epidemiological studies found that for every 12 months of breastfeeding, the risk of developing breast cancer was reduced by 4.3%. Findings from a case-control study of more than 400 women with ovarian cancer suggest that even short-term breastfeeding reduces the risk of developing ovarian cancer. Weight gain is a normal, healthy part of pregnancy. Losing weight after pregnancy is difficult for many women, but those who breastfeed are more likely to return to their pre-pregnancy weight, and they typically do so sooner, within the first 3 to 6 months after delivery, than women who do not breastfeed. When it comes to breastfeeding, there are practical aspects and challenges. An important question that many mothers have is, how long should I breastfeed? As mentioned before, the American Academy of Pediatrics recommends exclusive breastfeeding for about 6 months, followed by continued breastfeeding as complementary foods are introduced, with the continuation of breastfeeding for 1 year or longer, as mutually desired by mother and infant. The World Health Organization also recommends exclusive breastfeeding for up to 6 months of age, with continued breastfeeding along with appropriate complementary foods up to 2 years of age or beyond. The first few days and weeks of breastfeeding present many challenges to new mothers, ranging from sore nipples and plugged ducts to lack of family support and other concerns. Working with a lactation consultant during the first few weeks of breastfeeding may be helpful. If a woman's milk is insufficient to meet the need of her infant, or if she has a health concern that prevents her from breastfeeding, donor milk may be an option for healthy, full-term babies. One more thing, it's important to realize that talking about the benefits of breast milk and breastfeeding infants is not the same thing as criticizing mothers who, for whatever reason, cannot or choose not to breastfeed. In summary, breastfeeding provides many benefits to both infants and mothers, including intellectual and emotional development in the infant, and protection against cancer and obesity in the mother. Breast milk provides a compensatory immune system for the infant. Breast milk is a complex, dynamic fluid that contains a multitude of nutritional and non-nutritional components, including immune cells, stem cells, and human milk oligosaccharides. Breast milk also provides a mechanism for the transfer of substances or drugs that the mother may inhale, ingest, or absorb to the benefit or possible detriment of the infant. Although breastfeeding presents challenges to some women, support is available.